stop by, hang out with us as we are looking for a brand new female co-host for the brand new year. So, you know what I mean? We're just going to be vibing and talking to certain people, man. So, you know, big shout to my girl, K-Dev. And hold on. Let me show you something. Once again, man, big shout to my man, Heineken, passing through, man. All love, every day, all day. All right, man. K-Dev about to step up in here. Shout my man, AV. And don't forget, today's show is also brought to you by Positivity Water. You always need that positive water in your life. You know what it is, man. Shout out to my girl, Sib. Team Epps in the building. Yep. And yeah, man, you know, next week we got more guests coming in. Oh, man. Music will be tomorrow. I'm going to jump on the turntables. We're going to play some music. I got music to break, man. I got E-Rain with that brand new joint O. Ooh. We got my man P. Smith with that Florida Water. We got World of Rama with that joint My Flowers. We got my man Born King featuring JM called Found You. Got some Cohen Capace up in here, man. Yeah. We got a lot of joints up in here, man. Trust me. All right, let me get my family up in here. Shout out to my man AV in the building. And we're going to have a special guest, my girl K-Dev in the building.
Hey,
K-Dev, what up? What's good?
What's going on, DJ F? How's everything?
Everything's good. How you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm actually in the studio right now.
That's awesome, man. What you doing? You working on some music?
Well, I have some artists actually going to do some new music today. I'm at social media. Shout out to Social Media House. I'm at, you know, It's Biscuits home studio over here. Shout out to It's
right.
Biscuits. Long Island. We're at Social Media House. So people are going to be recording tonight, and they have me sitting in. Also, I might be going to Tony Yayo and Uncle Murder's event tonight. So
that's right, man. When you see them, man, tell them.
Saturday,
tell
I'm coming to see you.
I'm pulling up to Queens, New York. I appreciate that, man.
You are. I took the day off just so I could come see you.
Awesome, man. We're going to have some fun, man. Tell Tony Ayo and my boy Murda I said what's up when you see them too, man. Those are my guys right there.
I definitely will.
Let me see where AV at, man. We're going to get my man AV in the building. AV is Alpha Villains, who we usually have here on Tuesday, every Tuesday with me. But AV is going to get ready to leave us very soon, man. He has his own show. AV, there he goes right there.
AV, how are you?
What's up? How you doing?
Good. AV, what's going on with you? You good?
I'm chilling, man. How you doing? What's good? Shout out to Team App.
You already know. And shout out to Rock the Bells that's just stepped in the building. Rock the Bells family.
Salute. Rock the Bells.
Catch me on Sirius XM, 9 o'clock every Saturday, Channel 43. Yeah, man, and 1 o'clock in the morning. So big shout to see my family, Rock the Bells, coming to Miami for Art Basel with Cheetos. Get ready for that. Yeah, party. It's gonna be a problem, man.
It's gonna be lit.
Yes, definitely. K Dev, this is my guy AV, man, and AV, you know, we on that talent search for a new co-host over here that's gonna be helping you out, man, to take over.
Nah, no doubt, man. I appreciate the opportunity. Yeah, it's got you got some big shoes to fill, but you know what I mean? Epp's gonna make it happen. So it is what it is. You know what I mean?
Nah, definitely. K-Dev, let everybody know where you're from.
So I'm from Long Island, New York. I was born and raised. I'm also heavy hitter DJ New Era's City Capital Movement team. I'm the only female DJ representing for the team, let alone New York in general. New Era's from Alabama. I'm also the CEO of the Queen of the Trap podcast. I'm about to be an iHeart Radio DJ for Jersey.
That's what's up.
Starting in a couple of weeks, we kind of had to put it back because the studio is actually being built and stuff like that for us. So that is coming relatively soon. I'm excited for that.
What part of Long Island? What part of Long Island are you repping?
I'm over in Kings Park.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because my mother moved to Long Island too, West Babylon, Suffolk County.
Okay, so she's probably only 15, 20 minutes from me.
Yeah.
That's what's
up. It's a different vibe over there. You know what I mean? Nassau and Suffolk County is a different vibe. They don't understand it.
That's true. That is very true. And it's all mixed out here. It's definitely all mixed.
K-Dev, I've been watching you. I want to say, you know, I started learning about you through the pandemic, and I've been watching you grow and grow and grow. And all those platforms you said that you work in and everything, I must say, man, you're doing a good job, and I'm proud of you. I don't think you need to hear that from me, but, you know, from us guys, we just want to say we're proud of you for working, man. And we recently seen you on a channel. No, was it TMZ?
It was TMZ.
Yeah, you was giving you was giving your thoughts and condolences to Takeoff family and whatnot and the Migos. Yeah. Talk to me about that, man. Talk to me about, you know, how TMZ reached out to you or you reached out to them. I don't know how that went down.
They reached out to me. That was like a huge blessing because I'm somebody I do use Twitter frequently, but I don't use it enough to where I actually go look at my Twitter messages. And the day before I actually saw the message, TMZ had reached out to me and they were asking me if I was ever interested in doing TV, talking about segments that are going on in the world right now and elaborating on it. So I was like, oh, yeah. But, you know, you have to make sure that those things are real. So I made sure that I went and looked at the page, see the followers and all that, make sure it was the real deal because I was kind of taken back. Like, they reached out to me. Like, and I'm somebody who only really started DJing 2 years ago. I mean, I've always had a love for trap music, and that was why I had a choice of segments to choose from to elaborate on. And I chose Takeoff because I was the only little white girl running around Suffolk County playing all of DJ Spinata, DJ Holiday, DJ Drama, all their mixtapes and stuff like that. So I grew up on Migos. Like, I remember when they started first putting out their mixtapes in 2008 and stuff like that. And I still be playing all those mixtape records and stuff. So when they gave me all these topics to talk about, that was the number one topic, and I was like, I'm going to stick with that. Now, the day that Takeoff actually passed away, it was supposed to happen, but so much news was being reported to TMZ that day that they were like, we can't even get you on the show today. So I didn't even think this was going to happen, but they reached out to me again that night, and they were like, we still want to get you on the show. So the next day we actually did the segment and everything like that. So I'm definitely blessed and definitely appreciative of the opportunity. Shout out to TMZ.
And so that you know that's what caught my eyes and says, because me and AV had a conversation. We were like, yo, we got to start, you know, looking for a new co-host. And we know. And when I saw that interview, I was like, you know what? I think we have our first runner-up. And that's when I reached out to you. And I think I did the same thing. I was like, have you ever, you know, done any news and anything like that? You know what I mean? So, yeah, man, that was great. Congratulations on that. So is there anything you want to bring up right now, man, that we could like, talk about, man? You want to? You told me
to give you some news for today, so I'm about to give you some news that's going on in the world. Number one, obviously, you know, Trump had went public today and announced that he is running for presidency once again. So yep. I'm actually excited for it. I was never a Trump supporter.
Why is everybody all of a sudden excited for Trump for running president right now again? Why is everybody excited?
He did the economy well. That's why. I feel like that he did us a little better than Biden is doing us right now. I felt the opposite during the time of the running when, you know, Biden and him were going back and forth with it. But after, you know, Biden became president and I started to see the things that he was talking about as opposed to the things that he's actually doing in this world today, I kept saying to myself, God, I don't even want to say this, but I want Trump back. Like, I want Trump back. So,
AV, what's your thought on that, man?
Yeah, I agree with her. I agree with her 100%, man. You know, Trump got taken out of office. It didn't really matter who it was as long as it wasn't Trump. So, you know, Biden isn't necessarily the best president. So at the end of the day, and he's old, right? So if you really look back, you know, Biden really wasn't really for the quote unquote minority. So I agree with her 1,000%. The economy is in a shit, is in the toilet right now. People can't afford food. People are deciding whether they're going to celebrate Thanksgiving or pay a bill. People, you know what I mean? There's a lot of shit going on. This is what attributes to all the craziness that you and I talk about on a weekly basis. So at the end of the day, it's always going to be the lesser of two evils. And I think that we've gave Biden an opportunity and a shot, and he's failing miserably at it. I think you don't know what you have until it's gone. So I think that now that we're kind of reminiscing and we're seeing that the holidays and things are getting more expensive, saying, you know what, it wasn't as bad as we thought. Yeah, Trump is an idiot. He says a lot of dumb shit. But at least the dollar stretched a lot farther than it does right now. So I'm with her 1,000%, man. Trump 2024, bro.
Listen, isn't it something like, you know, sometimes we got to take a step back to move forward type stuff?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. All right, cool, man. What else is on deck? What else is on deck? Talk to me, K-Dev.
So, being from Long Island, you know, there was a Gabby Petito case going on and stuff like that. You know, rest in peace, Gabby Petito. Last night on Jeopardy, they actually used the Gabby Petito case as one of the questions in Jeopardy, which was in 2021, fugitive Brian Laundrie had ended the days and fled to the creek area, home to these long-toothed critters. What is the answer to it? Number one, why are we even mentioning that? Like, number one, a female had lost her life unexpectedly. Yeah.
In a tragic way, right?
Right.
She literally only lived 15 minutes from me. And wow. The whole going over to her memorial and stuff like that, it was heartbreaking. So for somebody right. to even go on public TV and do a segment like that was trash. But
yeah,
Brian Laundrie's, you know, his his lawyer got involved and was like, "We are appalled, blah blah blah." Why are we hyping up this guy? Why are we hyping up Brian Laundrie? Like, I don't know.
That's the crazy shit about it. Yeah, that's the crazy shit. Like, I agree with you 1,000% once again, because it's insensitive. And this is what I always talk about, that the truth is always censored. I mean, right now we're crucifying Kyrie Irving and Kanye West for having an opinion on certain things. They're stripping them, they're making examples out of them. But yet, someone like you said, Petito, who lost her life tragically, we can easily talk about this segment or that particular scenario on a game show, and nobody, the producers, nobody's being held accountable. So at the end of the day, we always talk about it. Freedom isn't, you know, freedom of speech is non-existent. The truth is censored. Absolutely. It's the same thing when I talk about with Epps too. Like, I could say some shit on my podcast and I'll get flagged for it, but somebody else can say it and they won't get flagged for it. So at the end of the day, I agree with you. It's totally insensitive. And this is why I think everybody's so confused. We don't know what to say. We don't know what we can say. And this is why people don't have a problem expressing themselves. When was the last time you had a conversation with someone in person as opposed to having swipe right, swipe left, text them? Most people don't know how to fucking talk. And I'm an older dude, so at the end of the day, I really don't have a lot of fucking patience for the dumb shit. So I'm just like, okay, I can't do this right now. So, yeah, why are we having a conversation and making light of a situation of somebody's loss of life?
Do we think these producers and directors and people behind the cameras, you know, do you think that they hear what's really going on? Do you think that they know what's really going on?
I think that they do.
Do you think sometimes it goes over their heads?
Job at the end of the day, so at the end of the day, they can't have an opinion because they'll get fired, or the people behind the scenes, yeah.
Like, yeah, I think
I don't mean to cut you off, sorry. Like Dave Chappelle, I think, you know, a lot of people was not understanding some of his jokes what he was saying in SNL this past weekend. You know what I mean? And I think it went over a lot of people's head. You know what I mean? And, you know, they even try to clown Ice-T for even, you know, being part of the situation and stuff like that.
Yeah. So, again, it's all part of the narrative. You know, there's some people who say that the Will Smith and Chris Rock fiasco was planned. We never see again. This is the problem. We don't know what's fake and what's not. It's all about feeding and capitalizing on people's emotions. Now, you asked about the producers. I'm sure the producers were aware of the jokes, SNL jokes with Dave Chappelle. I'm sure they were aware of the answers and questions on Jeopardy. But again, you got a segment or a fraction of the people that want to get ratings, right? What's the cost of going viral and shit? People are doing dumb shit, hurting each other, doing crazy shit, showing their ass, twerking, just to get to go viral without the consequences. But at the same time, depending if you're having a bad day, if I'm in control and my girl didn't give me none or shit, or I'm in a fight with my girl and somebody says something crazy, I'm just going to pick on you and make you the example. So we all need to police. Social media needs to have a police system where everyone has an opportunity to express themselves. And when it goes a little too far, that's when we kind of draw the line. But unfortunately, the algorithm is controlling everything and nobody can figure out the goddamn algorithm because it's constantly changing.
Right, yep. Right. Anything else, K-Dev?
So, also, Mariah Carey got denied of a trademark of, now I'm the queen of the chat, but she tried to go for the Queen of Christmas and was denied.
Really?
She was actually denied by the U.S. trademark trial. She was denied it because she was trying to apply for it so that she could make hot chocolate, she could make merchandise, she could do Christmas things, and they denied it because she got a lot of backlash for it. Now, she applied for this back in March of 2021, and it was just today that it was reported that she was denied the fact that she got called that. She also tried to do the Princess of Christmas or Christmas Princess, and they denied her of that as well because of the backlash from people who were like Darlene Love and Elizabeth Chan. She's a singer. They said that she's like kind of manipulating Christmas. Christmas is about giving, not receiving. So she would be receiving the funds. She would be receiving this and that. So that's why I think that she was ultimately denied the trademark part of it.
Yeah, you know, I'm in the process of trademarking a couple of things, and you can always appeal it. It really gets really tricky when you're trying to trademark something. You have to really specify, and that's how they get you, too. For every class that you kind of, like, so for instance, for her, for Christmas, she would have to pay an exorbitant amount of money to kind of tie in what she means when we're mentioning Christmas, right? Because Christmas is such a broad word. So it's crazy. It's kind of like the White Lives Matter shit, you know, about the black radio people that bought that shit. That was brilliant. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, again, Christmas, yeah, but a lot of everybody celebrates Christmas. So again, it's the people who have the ability. It's like White Lives Matter. There's a lot of white people and lives are universal too. How can you market that? I think they allowed that to pass because Kanye West was rocking it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Why can't you say Queen of Christmas? So it's just...
got denied of the White Lives Matter trademark, I believe. I believe I read that he got denied that whole trademark because somebody else had owned it.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, the two black radio hosts decided to trademark the idea because they didn't want Kanye to use it in a way where other people, other races could capitalize, which I thought was a brilliant move. But again, if you're telling me that somebody can buy White Lives Matter, why can't I call myself the King of Christmas? It's just like a lot of shit that's just tricky.
But at the same time, everybody knows Mariah Carey is the All I Want for Christmas person. Every year she be
right. Yeah, that's a fact.
So,
right.
So that's why, at the same time, I feel like they should have gave it to her. But at the same time,
I agree.
There's a lot of politics behind everything, so we don't personally know those things.
And not to take the topic off of Mariah Carey, what's going on with Nicki and her not being, you know, nominated?
Hello, New York Queens. I grew up on Nicki. That's crazy.
Yeah, I don't.
Kalani wasn't nominated either. Wasn't nominated for anything either. She's had great numbers going on.
So are we trying to celebrate Nicki's last single that should have been nominated? Is that what we're talking about? Is that what we
would love for Nicki to be nominated for anything, because I grew up on her, and I'm from New York. That was one of the many female artists in the Trina's one of them. Ciara, stuff like that. So, like, the people that I grew up on, I absolutely think that Nicki Minaj should be nominated, because she's been in this game for so many years. And, you know, she's with Lil Wayne. You know, she signed to one. He's already in the Hall of Fame. Why are we not putting a female in this nomination?
What kind of politics do you think is behind this situation?
Male dominance, that's what it means.
You think so?
A lot of male dominance in this industry. We're trying to break the barrier, though. Us women are trying to break the barrier of, it's so male dominated out here. How many female DJs do you personally know? There's a lot of female artists, but how many female artists are really getting put on back then to nowadays? We're trying to break that barrier.
You don't think it has nothing to do with the music?
Yes and no. I want to say this. Shout out to MP3 Wax. They were people to tell me that this is the year for the females to really come up and stuff like that. But we should really be bringing back R&B tracks. What females nowadays really put out R&B? We're all putting out rap and all this stuff. So I feel like maybe if we did, yes, so I can agree with you. If we change the narrative a little bit, if we change the sound, if we stayed away from so much of the ratchetness and really put our hearts and souls into the music, then yes, I feel like, you know, we would come up a little bit faster. But at the same time, we're not allowed to, we can't really break those records in the club.
Yeah. I understand. AV, you know Rick James' history, right?
A little bit, yeah.
And when I say history, I'm talking about the bad things that he did.
Yeah, for the most part. Yeah, that's unfortunately sometimes, again, you can do a couple, sometimes a few infractions or bad things will ever outshine your talent and shit like that. But yeah, I remember.
I don't mean to get a little deep, but I thought about it. I was like, I don't think they respected Nicki's single because of that.
Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
That's like sampling a song from R. Kelly, and it just goes, it's bananas. Everybody loves it, da-da-da. But is the award shows going to be like, are we celebrating a sample from R. Kelly,
well, that's my,
you
know what I mean? That's my.
That's like little that's like little baby go sample a song from R. Kelly, and next you know he's been little baby's been nominated for best record of the year, but you hear nothing but of a R. Kelly sample, and you know we're not celebrating R. Kelly at all. You know.
Yep. Well, that's a very good point. I think in this day and age with feminism and women empowerment, and not necessarily just in the industry, I'm talking about in general. And the Me Too movements and shit like that. When you talk about Rick James, aside from his talent and his contributions to music, I'm Rick James, bitch, and shit. Cocaine's a hell of a drug and all that shit, the domestic violence shit. When you tackle that on, you're glorifying it. But at the same token, Epps, what about the shit that Megan Thee Stallion did with Anaconda and you know what I mean? All the pussy shit. So once again, we all have valid points here on this panel. However, again, it's always going to be a double standard, not necessarily with men and women. It's all about whether they like you or not. So at the end of the day, sometimes you're going to be made an example of, sometimes you're not, despite your fucking talent, whether you're talented or not. If they don't want you to get put on, they don't want you to get put on. Right. So as a recipient of somebody getting hated on, you have a choice. You're either going to fall victim to the hate, or you're just going to try to work harder or circumvent the hate. That's what differentiates champions and winners. All the people that we see on top, the Nickies, the Murder Inks, Jay-Z's, Nas and shit, they had to go through this fire to make them the greats. And so at the end of the day, everybody's faced with adversity. Everybody's faced with biases. When Jay-Z got caught cheating on Beyonce, he was in the doghouse. So everybody goes through this. And I think that you learn from these situations. So Nicki will be fine. This isn't her first fucking Grammy. This isn't her first Emmy. I think Nicki's just feeling her feelings because she hasn't had a big hit in a while because Cardi B was stealing her shine. I mean, so hey, that's what it is.
I think you're right on that. I think both, like you said, we all got a great opinion on this situation. Let's talk about one more thing before we get up out of here, man. And it just hit the news right now. And that's your boy Blueface.
I was just ever have that written down too. I was just
man, what yo, how this just came out of nowhere. Like
nobody knew about this, number one. But there was 6 to 8 unmarked cars waiting for him outside of what was it called? Los Chicken and Waffles. Mm-hmm. And they picked him up, they put him in handcuffs. Now, apparently, something had went down where he had additional charges on. He already had a warrant out for his arrest. They were just, like, watching him. But apparently, he had charges for firing a firearm or a use of tear gas, was what I read. Tear gas or a firearm, felony attempted murder, and he had additional charges on top of that. So I don't know who it is. You know, his girl, Rock, she had posted today, like, why would you take my man? That's a whole messy situation. But as far as Blueface, like, I didn't know any of these things went down. And nobody really knew. It just got sprung on us today.
But I guess we're just going to have to sit back.
In general. He's a messy
But for murder, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know?
So.
It was. I mean, I don't know who it is. I don't think any of us know who it is at this point. But when it comes out, I feel like it's going to get even worse. Like, the whole topic
Right. You got to understand, too, like when they tack on these murder charges, a lot of them don't stick. It's just because of the technicalities. Right. So let's say, for instance, I had a gun and shit, or I had a blunt object I was fighting and shit, and I hit the person on the head. That could be considered attempted murder, even though I had no intentions of killing the guy and the guy was fine. So when they first get you, they're going to tack on some charges and shit. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, that's good for the prosecution and for the cops and shit like that. But, you know, and again, it makes news, right? It makes news. We don't know if it's fake. We don't know if it's real. We don't know if it's part of a fucking, maybe he's coming out with a goddamn album. Who the fuck knows? But at the end of the day, we have to just wait and see. You know, the internet is a good thing and it's a bad thing too. Everyone has access to the news and everyone wants to report the fucking news. It's our job to differentiate to see what news and what isn't.
Right. Right. And I think Bloody Bay Entertainment said it right. Vegas don't play that shit, man, especially if you're from California. That back and forth from Vegas and California could get a little tricky. And they could – I mean, I think Blueface was just as surprised as we are.
He got taken in.
Yeah, he was just as surprised as we was, man. And I hope it's what you said, man. It could be a little minor, you know, thing. But then again, we just got to wait and see what it is. Everybody, man, thank you for chiming in. That's on the comment box. We appreciate you guys. We want to say thank you to DJ K Dev for passing through, hanging out with us, and just vibing with us. Nah, not a problem, man.
And I hope to be a co-host in 2023.
Yeah, man. We hope something goes down, man. So we're gonna figure this part out. AV, man, let them know about your show in the morning and everything before you get up out of here.
Yeah, man, I appreciate you, Apps K Dev. It was a pleasure meeting you. Do me a favor, guys. When you get a chance, get off this live. Go to YouTube. Type in Alpha Villains. I got a YouTube channel. Morning show, finish your breakfast with AV. Weekday mornings, 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. On Thursday show, we're going to talk about red pill romance and what not to do if you are a quote-unquote red pillar. But like I said, check me out on Alpha Villains on YouTube and make sure y'all follow me on Instagram. I appreciate you.
And K-Dev, you want to give any information before you get up out of here?
Follow me, DJ K-Dev. I'm on all platforms, Queen of the DJ K-Dev, Queen of the Chat Podcast. Like I said, I'm on Heavy Hitter, DJ New Era, City Cap Low Movement. I also didn't mention that I work with Jim Jones, Vamp Life Records, and his artist, Mark Hanson, who's out in L.A.
It's my brother.
I'm coming to New York to actually be shooting a video in the next couple of weeks. So make sure that you check out Mark Hanson as well. I just thank you guys. And
appreciate you.
You know I love you, your family over here. And it's so nice to meet you, Alpha. And
Likewise.
You know what it is. Thank you, K-Dev. Thank you, K-Dev. And we also want to thank Heineken for passing through today as well, man. Everybody. Yeah, man. Everybody. Oh, man. I'm pretty sure you guys going to meet up very soon, man. Great guy. You know, shout to This Is 50, shout to Bag Fuel Podcast and all that, man. All right, man. Everybody, man, I want you guys to have a good night, man. And
appreciate
man,
you.
Meet me back here tomorrow at 10 o'clock when I get on the turntables and start breaking records and fucking up these turntables like I do all the time, man. So, yeah, you already know. For AV, for Heineken, for my girl K-Def, thank you for hanging out. I'm going to leave you with this brand new joint. From New York City, his name is E-Rain. It's called Live and Direct for you and yours right here on the DJ Epson Friends. Y'all have a good night, all right? Shit. I know that you feeling it. Hey. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know it's time we running in this girl. Hey. I've been on some killing shit. Hey. I know that you feeling it. Hey. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know it's time we running in this bitch. Ooh, I've been on some killing shit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know it's time we running in this bitch. Ooh, I've been on some killing shit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know it's time we running in this bitch. I'm sick of the fake. I'm sick of the lies. Wait. They smile on my face, but hate in their eyes. Wait, wait. They tell me to fly, but hate when I rise. Wait, the closer I get, the more that they try. Hey, I've been on some killing shit. I know that you feeling it. Too legit to think to quit. See, I'm really with the shit. Trying to knock me off my game. Had to practice on my aim. Bumps and bruises, all just losing. Nothing ever was the same. Nah, the only way to get it is to grind for it. That's only if you really want to shine for it. No. It's all that I'm designed for. See the pressure, I just love when they apply more. I've been on some killing shit. I know that you feel it.